Did you know that there's text presets within Final Cut Pro all ready to go and stylized? We're going to show you where they are, because they're kind of hidden right over here.
Let's start by dragging a title into our timeline. Navigate to the top left and click on the Titles and Generators icon. And we'll double-click on this custom title to add it to the timeline. Make sure the playhead is positioned over the title so we can see it in the viewer. Now let's apply a text preset to our title. Navigate up to the inspector on the top right, and if for some reason your inspector isn't showing, click on this icon. And make sure the text inspector icon is also selected. At the top of the text inspector, click on this extra large drop-down that says Normal. And I'll bet you didn't know about this hidden gem, the Preset Styles pop-up menu. In here, you can choose from several pre-made 2D or 3D styles graciously provided by the Final Cut Pro team. Here's an example of a 2D style and a 3D style. What's even more exciting is that you can use this functionality to create and save your own custom text presets to use again and again in the future. Let's apply some changes to our text, like this font and size, as well as the tracking and position. But why stop there? Let's change some appearance settings, like color of the face. And maybe we'll add a cool glow effect as well. If you want to learn more about the text and appearance controls, check out our videos linked in the description below. To save the text style, click on the Text Presets menu and choose from one of the following save options. Save Format Attributes saves the basic text attributes we've adjusted, like font, font size, and spacing. While Save Appearance Attributes saves the text color, outline color, glow, drop shadow, and any 3D effects we've applied. Or we can save all format and appearance attributes to save every change we made on our text. We'll choose that one. Now we'll type in a name for our new preset. And just hit enter to save. To apply the preset to another title, select the title in the timeline, and then choose the preset in the Preset Text Styles pop-up menu. Would you look at that? It's exactly what we did earlier.
If you feel like we're moving a little bit too quickly, just take a deep breath, step back, and come back when you're ready.
Over time, you might end up with a lot of text presets, so we'll show you how to organize them into categories. First, exit out of Final Cut Pro and open up a Finder window. Navigate to the top menu, then hold Option and click on Go. Then choose Library. You may be in this view, but we'll change our view to Columns so it's easier to follow along. Now, click on Application Support. Then scroll down and click on Motion, then Library, and finally, Text Styles. You'll see the custom text styles you've created. We'll switch back to Detail View to show the file types. Each text style has three corresponding files: a document, a PNG image for the menu, and a regular PNG image. We can organize our presets by creating a new folder. Its name will be the name of the category we'll see in Final Cut, so we'll name ours Favorites. Choose a preset you like and drag all three of its corresponding files into that folder. We'll drag this other preset there too. Now let's go back to Final Cut Pro. Reselect a title in the timeline. When we open our Preset Text Styles menu, we'll see that the two presets we chose are now under the Favorites folder. Last but not least, let's go over how to remove custom text styles. First, make sure Final Cut Pro is closed. In the Finder, navigate to that same text styles folder. For each text style you may want to remove, select the three corresponding files. Right-click and select Move to Trash. Back in Final Cut Pro, the deleted text styles will no longer appear in the menu.
Now you can create your own custom text styles in Final Cut Pro and save them too.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.
Hey everybody, like, share, subscribe if you're looking for more education on Final Cut Pro.